Good morning, and welcome back to the Roundtable. I'm Sarah LaDuke. Barrington Stage Company in Pittsfield, Massachusetts opens its first main stage show of the season this week as artistic director Alan Paul directs Cabaret. Set during the twilight of the Jazz Age in pre-war Berlin, Cabaret is Kander and Ebb's party at the end of the world, with a book by Joe Masteroff based on the play by John Van Druten and stories by Chstirtopher Isherwood. Cabaret will play in Pittsfield on the Boyd-Quinson Mainstage June 14th through July 8th. Krysta Rodriguez will take on the often bobbed and never forgotten role of Sally Bowles. Rodriguez's Broadway credits include Into the Woods, The Addams Family, In the Heights, the original and the revival of Spring Awakening, The Collaboration, and Good Vibrations. She played Liza Minnelli in the Ryan Murphy miniseries Halston and had roles on Daybreak, Smash, Trial and Error, Gossip Girl, and more. Once again, Krysta Rodriguez is playing Sally Bowles in the Barrington Stage Company production of Cabaret. Krysta, welcome to the Roundtable.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
What does it mean to you to be playing Sally Bowles in Cabaret?
Oh, my gosh. I mean, it's an understatement that it's like the role of my lifetime. I've just been wanting to play it since I was young. And it's so special to me because when I saw it, I was 15 and it sort of was an aspiration. It was like one day you could possibly be a woman that could embody all the skills to be able to do this. And, you know, it took me a while to get here, but I feel like it's the right time, it's the right place. And I feel honored that I've become that person that could take this challenge on.
What was the first iteration of it you saw, of the movie or of stage version?
I saw it on Broadway.
Okay.
With my friend and at the time mentor, Susan Egan, playing Sally, and I was just blown away by the whole thing. I remember coming home because I had gone on like a trip to New York. So I came home to my parents and just told them all about it. And so that was the first time I'd seen it. You know, I hadn't seen the movie until somewhat recently when I got the honor of playing Liza Minnelli on the TV show Halston. I had to research all of her roles, and that was the first time I actually saw the movie. So the musical has really been the thing that's sustained me through all these years.
How has your interpretation or relationship to the character of Sally Bowles evolved over the years to make you feel like now is the right time for you to be able to play her? What are some of the things that the character goes through or experiences or puts out that you feel ready and excited about embodying during the production?
Well, there's a lot about her that's always been true to me, which is that she's a survivor, she's a fighter, she has overcome a lot, I always felt, in the backstory to be where she is, and has a lot of charm and is sort of fun and easy to get along with, but then has this darker side. So I was always intrigued by that. I think all of that's always been, you know, what I've wanted to try my hand at. What I think is really interesting about how it's happening now is that Sally can really be a lot of ages. You know, in the book, which is where she, the true story of Chris Isherwood, who wrote the Berlin stories, is that she is 19 years old, I think. She's super young. And throughout this musical, she sort of can be at any age. And I think putting her at the age that I am, which is about to be 39, I think is so interesting. And I think it's what I'm able to bring parts of who I am as a woman and a performer. And that feeling of, while the world is sort of caving in, where do you belong in that world in the next phase of your life? Where do you put your career? Where do you put potentially a partner and a family? Where do you put all of these sort of things that should come along with you in this phase of life, but maybe haven't sorted themselves out yet? And I think that's been really interesting to bring to this character, to show what it's like to be a woman at the precipice of a large change.
Sally Bowles in the show of Cabaret goes between performing for the audience, you know, book scenes that are the story of Cabaret, the plot of the show, and performing on a stage to the audience of the Kit Kat Club, which is also, of course, a performance for the audience of Cabaret.
Mm-hmm.
Is off stage Sally Bowles different than on stage Sally Bowles as you're playing her, as you're exploring her off stage versus her on stage?
The question we keep dabbling with in this version is the difference between putting on an entertaining show for the people who are coming to Barrington Stage and wondering why these performers wouldn't be further along in their sort of career aspirations, you know?
Right, yeah.
And part of that has been really tricky. And I think what it is that for Sally, potentially she's a bit of a self-sabotager. Anytime anything gets a little bit close, she needs to kind of push it away. So what's been fun to explore is when she's performing in the Kit Kat Club, she's really trying. She really wants to, her career is very important to her. Even if she's in the seedy club, she says the seedy little dive, I think that is somewhat more of a sex performance club in a lot of ways that would be more accurately in Berlin at that time. And she's trying to, you know, bring a little class, bring a little performance, bring a little pizzazz and get discovered there. And it's just like the wrong place for her to try to, to climb out of, you know? Mm-hmm. And then when she gets to sing, you know, she only sings one time, not in the club. And that is maybe this time, which was added from the movie. And it happens in a scene. And in this version of it, we sort of invite the MC in and invite the sort of elements of the club to come in, because to her, and you know, where we end at the end of the show without spoiling anything, you know, she really does put a lot on the line for what she believes to be what she deserves in her career. And I think working out her emotional sort of vulnerability through the song is too painful unless she can put it into a performance mode a little bit. So while it's very open and vulnerable, she has to kind of put it in context of what would the performer in me want? How would I access these emotions? I have to do it by performing.
What is the choreography for this production like, and how's it going learning it? Are you having a good time belting and dancing?
Yeah, I'm having a good time at the gym trying to figure out how to get the stamina to belt and dance at the same time. We have our choreographer, Katie Spellman, who is wonderful and really she's done this show a lot of times and has done a lot of thought behind the performers. And we've had a lot of discussions about the same things that I talked about how good is the performance? How rough and tumble is the performance, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's been really fun and character driven. And we have so many talented dancers, and it's just been a really collaborative process about sort of, I'm always very interested in telling the story through the movement. And so it's nice to have a person who is willing to go on that journey with me as well and figure out how it is. And then that way, if I do have to belt, I can take a second while everyone else keeps kicking.
I saw in a promotional video from the first day that everybody gathered for rehearsals that Barrington Stage's new artistic director and the director of your show, Alan Paul, called Cabaret a loaded fist in a velvet glove, which was, I thought, an apt and an interesting metaphor for describing the story of the show. Do you agree with that?
I absolutely do. And I think especially this production of it is doing that, and which is sort of a derivative from the revival that happened because we're using that script, which I think that they took the original script and pared it down to really the essentials of what is it like to be, like it says at the end of the play, it was the end of the world and I was dancing with Sally Bowles and we were fast asleep. You know, what happens in the day-to-day minutia of life when the world is ending, and how you can get distracted by the world at large, but also need the small things to survive. The laughter and the joy of a family can continue through horrific things happening in the world. So it's a very complicated thing as us as humans. We have so many survival mechanisms in place, and it doesn't always allow us to see when things are falling apart. And I think that's what this play is about. And in this production that we're doing, it's sort of also letting the audience know that they've been forgotten. They've forgotten all their troubles being entertained by this show and then realizing that this is actually still happening outside and it's time to go out and keep doing something. So I think that it's a beautiful show. It's got, especially the songs by Kander and Ebb are very uplifting. There's very few ballads. They're very entertaining. They're larger than life. They're all metaphorical. They're all, you know, they all have a lot of performance value to them, so that when you drop in at the end, you get that gut punch and you realize that you've sort of been drawn along this pretty primrose path to the end that is not as beautiful.
Krysta Rodriguez is playing Sally Bowles in Barrington Stage Company's production of Cabaret. BarringtonStageCo.org for ticket and showtime information. Krysta, it's been marvelous speaking with you. Thank you so much for your time, and I can't wait to see the production in Pittsfield.
Thank you so much.
I'm Sarah LaDuke, and you're listening to The Roundtable on WAMC.